Hello and welcome. In this video, we go deeper into understanding radar signal interference detection and mitigation. Today, we have Zigang Yang with us. Zigang has more than 20 years of experience in signal processing, and she has been researching about radar signal processing for several years now. Welcome, Zigang.
Thank you, Bhavan. Glad to be here today.
Let's start with why. Why it is important to detect and mitigate interference?
Interference can affect radar performance in many different ways. Let's talk about some of the key challenges here. The first one is misdetection. In the presence of interference, the noise level increases. It results very often in a misdetection for the weaker object. If the interference persists long, it can create a blind spot in some regions. The second challenge is ghost detection. The radar can detect an object that doesn't even exist. That can happen when the radar, victim radar, and aggressor radar have very similar waveform. Imagine applications like our lane change assistant, blind spot monitoring, and other ADAS and automate parking applications. Misdetection and ghost detection can really affect system performance and affect user experience. That's why interference detection and mitigation are very important for automotive radar.
So, what are the ways to detect this interference?
In general, interference can be detected by monitoring the glitches in time domain signal. TI millimeter wave device have this built-in mechanism that monitor the signal and detect interference with high precision.
So now, as we have detected this interference, how to mitigate it?
There are several techniques can help to mitigate interference. MOSARIM, also known as More Safety for All by Radar Interference Mitigation, is a European-funded project that published their result in 2012. In their report, they highlight 8 different techniques to mitigate interference. I'll give 2 examples here. One recommendation is to create a variation in time, either time domain or frequency domain between chirp to chirp. By creating this variation, interference will happen more randomly and the impact will be less severe. Another recommendation is to repair signal. Once you detect the interference, you can go back to the original signal and repair it by techniques like our interpretation.
So, what are the ways TI devices support this interference detection and mitigation?
As I mentioned before, TI have this built-in mechanism that monitor the signal and detect interference. Regarding the interference mitigation, out of 7 out of 8 technology that mentioned in the MOSARIM report is supported by the TI millimeter wave devices. The only one that doesn't support is antenna polarization, which is out of the scope of the device, but can be still implemented on the system level.
And you know, there is a recent release of Interference Detection and Mitigation Lab. Can you share a few words regarding that?
Yeah, recently TI released our Interference Detection and Mitigation Lab to demonstrate different technologies for interference mitigation. This lab includes our reference software that was a plug-in to the millimeter wave SDK. What is that means to a user is if they are using TI millimeter wave SDK for development, then they can integrate this feature very easily within several minutes. Also, come with this lab, there's a lab GUI that shows the signal, the noise level will increase in the presence of interference, and users can enable our mitigation technology by click a button and the noise and see the impact of the noise level.
Thank you, Zigang. Thanks for being here today.
My pleasure.
With that, we come to the end of this video. We hope this has been very helpful to you, and you can introduce radar signal interference detection and mitigation as a part of your radar sensor development using TI AWR family of mmWave sensor. These are one of the most integrated and easy to use mmWave sensors out in the market right now. So please check out more details about these devices at the link below. Thanks for watching this video.